I greet you in Jesus' name and welcome you to this precious moment of God's Word. Yes, true messages are scarce in our days, but God has prepared His vessel, Apostle Bola Medino, the president of the Called Out Ministry, Alagbado Lagos. This expository teaching of the Bible will enrich, lift, and heal lives today. So relax and be blessed as you listen to this message.
Father, I ask of you,
Baba, mo bere lowo yin,
that you will speak again
igbe efohun lekan si,
and address the issue of money in our lives.
Yes, so, nipa oro lori owo lori aye wa.
Lest unbelievers make mockery of us.
Ki awon laigbagbo ma ba fi wa sesin.
We declare and decree
asoja de ase pase
re pelu money is our servant.
Igbe owo yo je iranse wa,
no longer our master.
Yo je oga fun wa mo.
No money will take us to hell.
Owo ni mu wa lo si orun
akade. We will have money in this world to serve God, to help our family members, to build the church of Jesus, and to propagate the gospel. Thank you because our money has come from you.
In
Jesus' mighty name I pray, and everyone said,
Amen.
Everybody jam your hands together for Jesus. You are not clapping for Jesus, you are clapping for me. Jam your hands together for Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
How to spend your money as a child of God. In Haggai chapter 1, from verse 1 to 15, there God was explaining to the children of Israel about the displeasure He had concerning them. God was displaying His displeasure to the children of
Israel
over what they have left undone. He told them, my house lie desolate, and you are building duplexes, and you are having fun all around, pretending as if you know nothing about the desolation of my house. And he began to tell them, lack and famine are coming, that hunger will follow, that those who are civil servants among them, when they collect their salaries, they will put it into a leaking pocket. Amen. And he said, those who are farmers, by the time they reap, they are going to have sorrow over their harvest. And even the little harvest as a turnover they have for the work of a whole year, as soon as they bring it home, he said, I will blow on it, I will fan it away. And he said, I will give them a clean teeth. What's the meaning of that? You know that it is when you eat that your teeth will have to remain certain particles of the food you ate. But when you have not eaten anything and you have brushed your mouth, you will see how neat it will be. Do you know that if you don't eat, your teeth can smell? You don't know. Learn it today and begin to notice it. That is to tell you the magnitude of God's displeasure concerning His children, because to Him He has blessed them, but the people are not reciprocating His kind gestures. How to spend your money as a child of God, in order not for yours and mine to be like the children of
of Israel we are talking about today. Let's learn fast and be ready to obey the master. God does not have too many commandments for unbelievers, but he has several statutes, commandments and instructions for his children who profess to know him and they are serving him holiness and righteousness. And when you look at 2 Samuel chapter 24 verse 24, 2 Samuel chapter 24 verse
24,
and the king said unto Arauna,
Nay,
but I will surely buy it of thee at a price. Neither will I offer burnt offerings unto the Lord my God of that which does cost me nothing. So David bought the threshing floor and the oxen for 50 shekels of silver. It is amazing, people of God, particularly this 21st century, how people spend their money. Children of God in question, those who profess to know God by demonstrating some religious jamboree. But God and his work has no say on their money. They are so miserly towards God. They prefer to waste their funds on fantasies, frivolities and vanities of life, instead of releasing their money for God's use. To them, every money given to God or towards his work is a waste of time, waste of effort. They do not know that the money spent on oneself has no eternal record and cannot be blessed of the Lord. Therefore, begin to cut off unnecessary spending. I'm asking you and I'm commanding you that you begin to cut off unnecessary spending on trips abroad, partying, reckless spending, and sheer demonstration of wastages, all because you have the time, you have the power, you have the position, the resources are there, and the good health to flaunt it. Be told that you will give account for those things on the last day. Therefore, spend now and divert your time. Yes, spend now all what you have for God so that your reward will not be missing. I'm bringing this out in our Sunday school that we have taught you and will still be teaching you. I've made up my mind never to pastor a poor church and never to defraud my church members. I've made up my mind never to allow you go your own way, but to do things in line with the will and custom of heaven, so that you will know what it actually takes to serve God and to receive blessings from him. If you have been wasting your time and spending unnecessarily, I'm counseling you to repent and begin to divert your time, your talent, your energy, your position, your possession, your money, your resources, and your entire lifestyle to the service of God and that of humanity before you are called to give account of your still worship on that dreadful and merciless day. How to spend your money as a child of God. I have 12 points for you. Very, very shortly. There are profitable ways of spending one's money before God. And there are devilish way of spending one's money before the Lord. God will want you to learn. Lend me your ears. Suspend whatever you are doing now. Have a place to sit and tune on your spiritual antenna to hear from the master suggestions on how to profitably spend your money as a child of God. In Psalm 32 verse 8. Psalm 32 verse 8. Hear the word of God. I will instruct you. I will teach you in the way you ought to go. I will practically guide you with my eyes. I will not allow you to go astray in your spending, in your dressing, in the choice of your friendship, in your hobby, and in the choice of your complaint. What you entertain in your heart, I will teach you. I will instruct you on the right things to do part-time, if you allow me, and I will be guiding you with my eyes lest you go astray. Three principal things you need here as a human being to make it on time. You need instruction. You need teaching. You need guidance. And that's why God is saying, attend to my instruction. Accept my teaching. Allow me to lead you. And you will be sharing testimonies. For example, this week, the Lord will give you unprecedented miracles.
Amen.
How do I spend my money profitably as a child of God? Number one, make God the executive chairman over your life, over your ambition and your resources. Number two, give generously to the poor. Give generously to the poor and the needy in your church and around you. Fingers can never be equal. God has blessed you because of certain people who do not have the wherewithal, as it were, around you. It will be tantamount to wickedness on your account seeing such people with the quantum of the resources of God at your disposal, and you are pretending as if you are less concerned. Because of the needy, because of the poor, God has taken you to that position. God has brought you to a place of authority because of the people He wants you to help, because of the people He wants you to lift up, because of lives He wants you to affect positively. God allows the resources to come to you. God allows you to be rich, and God put you where He has put you. But rather than using the resources rightly, you can the blessing and you sat on it. How may that affect others positively? What if God had to deny Christ of coming down to die for you and to die for me? Then you and I will have been lost forever. God loved the whole world, but we cannot tell the parameters of His love until He gave His only begotten Son. If the Bible had stopped at the phrase of "for God so loved the world," all of us would have been lost on transit as per what is the parameter, what is the depth of His love for humanity. But He gave His only begotten Son. One Son. He released Him. What if He did not come back to life? Then He would be left with nothing. Imagine that. As a child of God, let it be known to you that whatever you have and whoever you are, they all come from God. All I have came from God. All I am is from God. I owe God thanks, and I must give them back to God. Many of you will not leave the level where you are because you are too miserly towards God. You are too miserly towards the people. How much of your own load and responsibility do you think you can show that on your own self without the help of God? Give generously to the poor and the needies around you, and particularly in your church. I'm not talking about Babiala people. It is the responsibility and the spiritual allocation for Babialas to beg around because they don't know God. I don't give my resources to Babialas. I give my resources to God and fellow Christian believers like myself who loves and serves God, but they do not have as much as the cool. As much as the Lord will help me, I'm ready to assist everyone, but not that people should capitalize on my simplicity and generosity, and every now and then you are coming and coming, I will send you away. Strive to be a giver yourself and not just the haver. Give me, Lord, I need this one, sir, give me this one. Be a giver yourself. Look at me here. Until you begin to give, By the same proportion of the fellow has been given to you, you will never value what that man has been doing for you. He gives me 10,000. Yourself, get up tomorrow, give 10,000 to somebody. You will know that the fellow who gave you 10,000 is not a bastard. If you don't know how to give, you will never appreciate whatever anyone does for you. So many people, when you give to them, they feel that it is their right. Why am I a church member there, when they cannot shoulder my responsibility? See, you are not a church member if you are like that. You are a liability. We will soon send you away. We don't need liabilities in the church.
Say,
I can't go to that church. They are not ready to pay my house rent. Are you normal to talk like that? How many people are in the church that we have to be paying their house rent? How much of income do we generate as a church per month? You come to church, you give 20 naira. After all the saliva in my mouth has been exhausted, before you can bring it, and now you are in need of
60,000.
You want the church to shoulder it. You are only barrow thief.
You are a thief.
So understand,
you are
only barrow thief. That's who you
are.
Oyochi.
Amen. Amen.
Give generously. Give to the poor.
Or
give wisely. You can never overgive to God. You can never overgive to God.
Oh, le fun Olorun ju bo se ye lo.
Keep giving and giving and giving.
Ma tesiwaju lai sare ninu fifun.
So long God has given you the capability to do so.
Niwon gba ti Olorun ba ti fun o ni agbara to re fe lati se be.
One day Daddy Gio said.
Ni ojo kan baba Gio wipe.
He said.
Won wipe.
Many of you in this redeem.
Opolopo eyin te wa ni redeem.
You are businessmen and businesswomen.
Te je olosowo lokunrin asi lobirin.
I'm not a businessman.
Emi onisoniso.
You may beat me as far as tithe payment is concerned. But when it comes to offering, none of you in the Redeemed Christian Church of God can beat me when it comes to offering.
See,
the secret of becoming prosperous in life is by giving, is by sowing, is by serving the Lord, is not by praying and fasting, is not by jumping from one mountain to another, is not by secretly wishing, being wistful, or how I wish that tomorrow I will become like this. As I'm going to the church, Lord, begin to reveal me to my pastor. Again, my pay, oh. Oluwa ma fi mi han pastor mi lojojumo ti pastor mi pastor ka ma ri mi emere ni ma ro ko ja o ma change adua lori e o ti kin kan ma ri o je Jesu ni ki pastor mi ma ri mi ka ma pe mo nilo aini ka ma pe mo ni kindi kan ka ma pe iwo nikan ki lo ti o te beju kokoro ni pa o lo yi o
jo ba fe
kokoro ni pa o lo yi o. Let's be careful as people of God. Number three, because of my time. Be an ardent giver towards revival and crusade programs. Be an ardent giver towards revival and crusade programs. Amen. Amen. Now we are having crusade. And we are not going to stop it. We're going to categorize our crusades into four different times in a year now by His grace. One per quarter. Therefore, ensure you participate. We need your money. Go and work and bring money. Don't steal. Don't kill. Don't defraud. Don't embezzle. Don't do anything shameful and devilish. But walk legitimately with your hands. Sweat and get money in the right way, both before God and in line with the law of our country. Then bring it. We will spend it for God. And your blessings will be increasing. Give me a good amen. I know you won't say much amen to this. But whether you say amen or not, I am expecting your money to work for God. Sir, are you doing anything yourself? See me after the service in my office for further explanation on that. Give towards revival and crusade programs. Amen. Number four, buy evangelism bus for your church if you can afford it. If you are hearing this message and God has blessed you to get the called out ministry and evangelism bus, call me after this message. We travel usually out of Lagos for crusades in other
states.
Rather than chartering buses and cars, when we get our own, the job becomes simpler or simplified. As a matter of urgency and priority, we need two evangelism bus now. Fully aircon. I don't need every push to walk kind of. If you send that one to us, I will tell you, reserve it for your son. Not us.
If I didn't do something, this one will defecate on this body. And the Lord touched his head, that brother.
Hello.
Hello.
Rimi.
Rimi. It's come and see me.
Thursday.
On Thursday.
Loba lobe.
And he went there.
Ne. Olorun ni n gbe moto fun.
The Lord said I should give you a car.
Yeah, na bayi ise gbe bayi.
And he now turned aside.
O Jerry Olorun ti mo nsin.
I trust the God that
Jesus
I
serve. Jesus me ti gba leti.
Jerry. Jesus has given me a slap.
Ngba Jesus re o gbe moto fun.
And the time is Jesus will give me a
car. Lagbara Olorun.
Mama.
Ah leti lati bi ju ogere lo ko to down.
You have to push it from here to ogere before it will start.
Amen.
Amen.
What?
You they push it.
BB so gere. You want to redemption camp ni o lati ko yi. Wa ti moto yen pelu. Ase ti awon moto yo ko so pe ewo nbo, eya o ajagbe ko du ko lu trailer o ti won mo ti ko to le down.
The other boy will say that give way, a menace is coming.
We need two brand new evangelism balls
of
buses. Let the Lord use you. Let the Lord touch you. Anybody, both in this church and outside this church, the Lord can use you to do that. You have gotten to that level. Don't be stingy towards your God. Don't be stingy towards your maker. How much can you give for the life of your soul? How much can you give for the sound health you are enjoying? You sleep at will, you wake up at will. This is not about the goodness of God. God and the favor of the Lord. You go to the hospital and see people who are dying on the sick bed. Those who are much more opportune to life than you are. Those who are richer than you do. Those who are educated than you do. Those who do business than you do. But they don't know God. They are sick with their businesses. They are sick with their money. They are sick with their resources. But see what God has done for you. He has favored you. What are you going to do for him? And you call yourself a Christian. And each time you say, I've heard that, he said, Oluwa.
By the time you say that we want to do God's service,
I'm at 5,000.
So
you say, Oluwa, no, that's in
here.
And you are doing God's University, you won 5,000. So, Oluwa, you say, Oluwa, no, that's here.
And your children
are in half a
keep
5,000. Keep well,
we don't need your 5,000.
But if 5,000 is what you can afford, God knows, bring it. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
How to spend your money profitably before God. As a child of God, I'm talking to believers. Believers are usually sensitive and focused in their dealings. They are sensitive, they are reasonable. Not talking to everybody. See, if you don't do anything for God, don't worry. You will come, you will meet that those things have been done. I'm telling you the truth. Don't run away because we are doing this, we are doing that. Don't run away. Stay. That you are there with us, we are doing it together. But it becomes an hypocrisy in your account if you can do something, but voluntarily you are unwilling to do is in between you and God. There are widows in this church. I never expected anything from them. And then they are still bringing. I can't imagine that. A widow will be bringing money to do something for God. What does she have? We ought to shoulder her responsibility. When that money came, I lifted it before God. I knew what I told God. And let's see what will happen. Is it not God? God is not man. I should lie. How to spend your money profitably as a child of God. Then number 5. Give your landed properties. Give your landed properties. Cash. And kind to the Lord. How? Freely. I heard concerning one woman. A pastor in the Redeemed Christian Church of God. Who lent a house for service. I can't imagine that. You are a pastor in the Redeemed Christian Church of God. You have a place for worship. In your house. In the same ministry where you are. And you said they should come and be giving you money. At what age? 60, 65 years. What do you want to do with money?
Jesus Christ was betraying his Lord. Were you there when Judas Christ was betraying his master?
Amen.
Amen.
Were you there? When Judas was selling his master, were you there?
Judas don't tell worry.
How come that you love money so much like this? And the redeemer was paying. Every year, this woman keeps increasing the fare. Every year.
I said,
after all, look at our camp now.
We'll
see what is happening redeemed. This is my own something. And for God's sake, that's not the only house we're having.
Hmm?
To call the long story short, she increased the fare. twice in a year.
Meji lo je ki owo yen ga si lodun.
The redeemed said they cannot pay.
Awon ojo ra pada na o le sanmo.
And she made up her mind.
O wa pinu oko re.
I will send them away.
Pe won le oja.
The redeemed paid.
Awon ojo ra pada o sanwo.
Then she now said,
o wa pe
I'm not even interested in giving this place to redeem anymore.
Oni mi o ti e nife si lati fi bi bai fun awon ojo ra pada.
I want to give it to another ministry.
Mo fe fun ise ro se.
That will not give me trouble.
Ti o ni yo mi le.
There are people like that. If you are like that,
to ba ri pe,
you are an illegitimate child in the kingdom. That's who you are. We don't need to color it. The redeemed left the place. Another woman like herself bought a property near
our
place and gave everything to the redeemed Christian Church of God. 3 years, no church came to ask for the other house. And she felt sick. And the Lord told her, you sent me out of your house. I am out of your life too. And I'm not coming back. That was how she died. Let's be careful. Don't play pranks with God. Particularly if you are a member of a living church. Another point. Pay your tithe and offerings regularly and correctly. God has blessed you so much that your tithe ought to be 5 million. Your tithe ought to be 5 million. And you are bringing
200,000.
The church may not know. The church may be seeing you as a pillar in their midst. Meanwhile, you are a cake not turned, and you are a termite in that church. Another point. Make God first in all your spending. Always give to God according to the level of his blessings in your life. People came to give offering in the days of Jesus in the temple. And Jesus was looking at them. A particular poor widow casted all her living into the treasury. And Jesus took knowledge of that. It is my desire that you, if you like, listen to this message. If you like, don't listen to it. God, you see, listen to this. It is possible to be coming to the same church, having the same pastor, hearing the same message, and yet our blessings are not equal. Are you getting me now? The value you place over the fellow ministry determines the virtue that flows into your life. If you are sitting down under a message, and you are sitting down there absent-mindedly, you will never be blessed of that message. We are talking about God. You must give your rapt attention to it. You are hearing a message like this. Oh, don't did you? Like say, horo. Oh, don't did you? Oh, fed you. Oh, Lord, by the Lord, we are nani. Say, oh, not even in the Sunday.
What's wrong with you that you are sleeping on the message like this? If you are not careful, I'll put another fan beside you so that heat can blow upon you. Can you sleep where you are making your
kunu?
That kunu will not be
possible.
Can you sleep where you are frying your bean
cake?
I'm asking you. Can you sleep where you are cooking your yam? And you are there in the church sleeping. Your cane is
to the.
Let me see you sleep. You will enjoy me like a white man smoking SM cigarettes.
Give to God. Give him. As if there will never be another time for you to do so.
I'm
making first in all you have. Making first in all your spending. Another point. Meet every need in your church. If the Lord has taken you to that level, there are some people, they are actually spending their money for God, but with wrong motive. Wrong motive. And you cannot believe it. I'm going to leave that church. Upon all have done in that church, a pastor cannot even call me forward. One day, I said, church, this man is indispensable. Clap for him and pray for him. See, if you are working for God and you are looking for men's clapping, you have taken your reward already. We will appreciate you, but not in a way that will make you to become pompous and egoistic. Because it's God you are doing it for, not for anybody. And he will compensate you in return. If your motive is right, didn't Jesus say, whatever the right hand is doing, the left hand should not know? Where do you put that one? I say, in that church, I bought them camera. We'll give it to you after the service so that we can rest. That church, I gave them Kobe Owumeta for rice. No worry. Whatever you are doing for the church of God, it's unbecoming of your mouth to be broadcasting it here and there, because God is never a beggar. But I believe that one good deserves another. Anyone that God is using for the called out ministry, beginning from you and me as well, you know now how much we appreciate people. I will keep on appreciating you. But don't allow that appreciation to get into your head. Because when you are all out for the appreciation of men, that means you are looking for flatteries. Yes, flatteries. And it's not going to be helpful. I want to close. How to spend your money as a child of God profitably. Meet every need in your church. If the Lord has taken you to that level, don't allow us to be talking and shouting, hey, we need this one, we need that one. Wawa, wawa, do di, si benye.
The time that we begin out to be saying it, we emphasizing it all the time, and all the saliva is out because we want you to do the work of God. This is unfair.
Pastor Paul Adefarasin said something. And that thing touched me. He said, as a Christian, I cannot borrow anything to meet my need and that of my family. But if it has to do with the service of God, I can beg anybody to loan me money to do it. See, holiness church members, They are highly dangerous.
They will give their pastor to too much thinking.
Hypertension.
See, it will begin to have hypertension.
Pastor, mother, mama.
The pastor will have to be giving himself to too much thinking. That is why we'll be thinking that he's having a video or prayer, or know that he is not doing so.
Pastor,
the pastor is not praying.
ni o ma gbin lai loyun.
And he will having a deep breath when he was not pregnant.
Pastor mo ranju lai lori fifo.
And pastor will having a body highs when he was not having headache.
Ori pastor mo calculate lai so ni shiro banki.
And pastor will have to do series of calculation where it's not a banker.
Tori opolopo omo jo.
Because of too much.
Omo jo mi ani nti mo ni.
So remember we say what I have.
Ki n to le fill any church yen.
Before I will release it in that church.
Ma ba won fa.
I will pull it with them.
Mi o ni soro.
I will not say anything.
Emi kan se mo mo ru eyan ti mo je ki n to gbagbo.
Am I not the
same? Iyan lo si nro bo se wa yen.
Is that what you are? Ru
eyan to je ko to gbagbo.
The kind of person you are.
Iyan na lo si tebati.
Is that what you are still standing with?
Why o gbagbo.
Ah, if you want to hear the truth.
O si kaka to change.
Nothing have changed at all.
Se wa na mo.
You also can tell.
Se bo mo.
You also know.
Oja lowo ti kere source lowo ti tobi loju awon eyan.
It is the market that money will has no value, but in the church it has a big value.
Ani mama chibike.
Say mama chibike.
Bete me go.
E fun mi lowo.
E lo leleyi.
How much is this?
Ani 5,000.
I pay 5,000.
Shimi.
Oh my God.
Ote wa cheap bayi.
This is too cheap.
Edakun.
Ejo.
Nje mo le san 4 ki mele to ku wa ni role.
Can I pay 4,000 and later
let no tie ni nkan ranu to fe ra ilo to po Olorun se lerin die.
And you are calling God to be a witness over this useless.
Am an source.
But in the church.
A fe ra lu.
That we want to buy drum.
Kamo eyan mu 2,000 wa.
That people should bring 2,000.
To ba ti ni se pelu church anybody o ma ba mi so ranu o.
When he
has me on the cobo.
Nobody should bother me because I have no.
Emi ti mo save ti mo fe ra jeans.
I that was saving because I want to buy jeans.
Ojo to ba ku abo jeans yen ni die awon kan si ni die.
The day you will die that jeans will pull it out of your trouser because
teru teru la wa a fi ru o bayi.
We will use calico to bundle you and throw you to the ditch.
Amo jeans yen.
But that jeans.
Bo si die lo mi.
We will give it to another fellow.
O n padi.
You are a miser.
O padi foluwa anti. O padi
foluwa. You are a miser. You are miser.
O padi foluwa.
You are miser. You are a miser.
O si je onigbagbo.
And you call yourself a believer.
Rara o.
No.
Ye padi mo.
Stop being a miser.
Lawo e.
Be generous. Bible
so pe.
The Bible says.
Owo alapon in la o mo sara. Bible wi pe.
Made fat. The liberal soul shall be made fat.
Thank you, sir. Bible wi pe.
The Bible says.
Enikan wa.
There was an individual that scattered it.
Kilo si onisi.
That increase.
Yes. Hello, me wasa.
There's another one.
Where will lost about?
You will find it in the proverb.
He said, "Me do now." He will we.
It's not my word. But you will find it in proverb. There's another one.
A mio chechere.
You
have to. Ngema kwa ibita yahunde toba yekato nkola mo farabale di oshodi ani alara.
There are some people because of the habit of their
kidney. But anima kwa affect your kidney load. He affect the kidney.
Instead of them, maybe to run out there, they say, "Ah, I will see how boy it in my body," not knowing that they are damaging their kidney.
Because
you do not understand. You do not understand.
Oh, how
he was a miser.
Yes. Bible we pray.
The Bible says,
"Ki si ai nere
to his own want."
Yes, to his own want or impoverishment.
To his own impoverishment.
On how
he hold it.
On how
he's older more than necessary.
Lord, do you?
This year,
mo fe ko je Christiane to ketan ninu fifi fun ni Christiane to ketan.
I will want you to be a Christian with a bow leg.
Sorry, I want to ketan.
Those with bow leg.
Once a rope subu,
you cannot fall them easily.
What about fair buy to ketanja?
If you want to fight with a bow leg,
to Obamura.
If you are not careful,
then you Obayo.
If you do not have one of your teeth removed,
you cannot let that mama eat your soul.
Thank your God that is still alive.
Let that mama eat your soul.
Thank your God.
Because any to keta balance bagaju.
Because a man with bow leg is more balanced than you.
You will see the ati popo.
Have you seen the ake at popo in the show?
Masha Oba no lu, Otoba seba ogiri loba.
If you want to beat them the way they will do you,
then no, then to keta.
Also, the man with the bow leg.
Oh my God, then.
If you say you want to fight him,
mo doje, mo doje. To ba keta pelu owo to ni foluwa.
If you not have a bow leg with the money you want to spend for God,
Olorun akeyin si o.
God can back you.
Tori akoko mi. Ni bow leg sense oro bayi
sir. Sir, how are you talking like this?
O doju eni.
That's the point of the
matter. Mo ti gbadua.
I've prayed.
Mo ti kon.
I've taught you.
ni ilana Olorun
according to God's will
ati ti Oluwa fe
and what God expects from
me ni sin mo godo bawi
now I must
bi oro
you.
Yes I'll bawi
we will rebuke you
o le ronun wo
so that you
be aye to nbe yi mi o like here
this life that you are living I hate it
mo fe nkan pataki fun oju nton be lowo re yi lo
I want good thing better than the one you have now
mo fe ko tesiwaju
I want you to progress
mo fe ka mo ni village to ti wa pe o nsin Olorun looto
I want you people from your family to know that true family from
village
from your village that you are serving
looto o nsin Olorun
that they will testify of the
true God awon oju egbe re te jo pari university ka pada wo kan so pe ah mo jo wu re o
I want your colleague that you finish with university together to later come back and say that ah we admire you.
Mo fola ti e toro o.
Awon
kan mo fola awon kan toro.
There are some people that will say that I'm asking God for your own kind of prosperity.
O se ye kori niyan.
That's how you ought to be.
Omo Olorun gbodo ma tesiwaju.
A child of God should have a progression.
Beni ninu ohun gbogbo.
In everything you do.
Let me close.
Eje should turn by you.
Suggestions.
Aba
on how to profitably spend your money as a child of God. Another point. Remember your parent. Remember your siblings. Remember your relatives. If you don't spend your money for God now, others will. And you will be ashamed on the last day for failure. Yes, to do so. Use your money for God so that your account in heaven will not be empty. Finally, remember the orphans, widows, and aged ones in your village. Have this one as food for thought. Money is a good servant, but a bad master. Stand to your feet.
Great. Thank you for your time to listen to this message. I'm convinced that God's word has touched certain areas of your life. So make that right and godly decision today and experience that desired positive change. For prayer or counseling, call 0802-864-7075 or 0807-978-0256. Or visit us at number 3 Oduomeru Street by CAC Buster, AIT Road, Alagbado, Lagos. God bless you.